Mithun, you studied public administration, I think maybe in great detail. Tell me, can study make one a better administrator? Is there any relevance?
Yes, sir. I can. I think studying public administration will make one a better administrator. But I cannot guarantee say that he will be better administrator than person who has not studied. One thing is, when we study public administration, we will have a knowledge about the terminology, knowledge about how the administration works. It should be coercive administration or it should be cooperative administration. We study about NGOs, what is their role in administration. We study about people, why.
But all this is knowledge.
Yes, sir.
Knowledge that one can gain when one is working or during training,
Yes, sir.
isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So in that sense, it's not really very useful.
No, sir. I cannot say it is not at all useful. I think the knowledge which we study theoretically, we can use it in the practical sense when the time comes.
Okay. Okay. Take one most serious problem in administration and tell me how you can help resolve it, or what is your advice?
Sir, one of the serious problem is the interface between the people and the government.
Okay.
The people, when they come to the government offices, they have less knowledge of how they can get the service, in what time the service will be reached to them.
Okay.
So when I asked my father about this, he said people should be informed, may not be directly, but indirectly also. So what he has done is, he has kept what are the certificates which MRO office will give to the people, at what time. He has written all these things on the walls of the office. So people
Okay.
can directly see them and they can ask the questions to them. People participation is one of the critical area the government has to address.
You mean it is giving information to the people? It
Yes,
is
sir.
not people's participation.
Yes, sir. Once they are informed, they will become informed citizens, and the change comes from the people.
Do you have any experience with government office?
Yes, sir. I have taken passport, I have taken the caste certificate, OBC certificate. As a customer, I have the experience, but not as a service provider, sir.
Sure. Tell me, what is your experience as a customer? What did you feel getting something like passport? Was it easy for you?
Yes, sir. It is. I did not face any problems in getting my passport. It was. They were very cordial with me. They were asking few questions.
About caste certificate?
Yes, it was also not without any hurdle, sir. But I was not sure whether I will get in 30 days or at 25 days. I couldn't ask that question to the MRO.
Finally, you got
Yes, sir.
in how many days?
I got in 20 days, sir.
You didn't face any problems?
No, sir.
You didn't bribe?
No, sir. Being my father,
How about using? Please tell me.
as a government service person, so I did not face any problem, sir.
See, that's how you got. That's very bad.
So personally,
You
I don't
used
have any.
this is actually the misuse of government power.
But
So that itself is corruption. You have to face a government office without any connection. That is when you will see the power of government office.
I was directed by my father, but I did not use his name, sir. In the passport also, I went myself and I have applied to the person.
Okay. You didn't use any other occasion? You didn't have any other occasion?
Small issues with the traffic police. I have lack of helmet. So.
Okay.
Honestly, I have given 100 rupees and I have
okay
went away from that.
Okay. Tell me, as a serious student of public administration, what kind of society gives rise to higher level of corruption?
The society which lacks belongingness leads to higher level of corruption, sir.
Society that lacks
belongingness towards each other.
Okay.
One of the main reasons for corruption is lack of belongingness. As you said, I went as my father is an MRO, I went through my father's name. So there was a belongingness among themselves. But there is a need for effective belongingness with the common citizen also. And person who is serving and who is being served, if there is a disconnect between these two people, then he will try to exploit that person.
You mean in the society people should, they should all feel one?
Yes, sir.
But then when, why is it that in some societies they don't feel one?
Sir, it is because of the selfish motives that I have to develop than the other person. Rather than a accumulative or a cooperative development, one feels when I should develop more than the other person. When he doesn't care of the other person, then the disconnect happens.
But don't you think inequalities contribute to corruption?
Pardon me, sir?
Inequalities. There are rich people and poor people.
Yes.
But the rule is equal.
Yes, sir.
So rich people corrupt. Rich people pay and then get things done.
Yes, sir. Inequalities is also one of the reasons for the corruption, sir. But inequalities has happened because of lack of belongingness. Rich doesn't belong, he doesn't belong the poor as same as the rich community. If a rich person has to serve a rich person, then he feels he is belonging to that community. Class belongingness is there. So inequalities is a subsidiary of the belongingness. For example, caste belongingness is there. A higher caste person feeling the other caste person, lower caste person as unequal, yes, it can definitely lead to the corruption, sir.
Mm-hmm. There is one thinker, Riggs, who talked about corruption in developing countries.
Yes, sir.
What are his ideas? Did he say that the people don't think that they belong?
No, sir. He did not say about belongingness.
Hmm.
He said about there is lack of accountability because of one institution has many functions and many functions are taken by one institution. He said about, for example, DC, district office has many functions to do. So when anything happens, he cannot concentrate properly on one department. And police, there are police is there, IB, RAW, CRPF, all this look after law and order issues. So when the actual things come, they will give the responsibility to other person. I am not concerned, the other department is concerned with this. This is leading to the corruption as per the Riggs. Multifunctionalism.
Something is forced to do too many things.
Yes, sir.
But that should lead to inefficiency. Why corruption? If one is asked to do two things and not able to do them, it will slow down. That's all. Why should it lead to bribing?
Sir,
he also talked about formalism. For example, there are rules.
Yes, sir.
But people don't think that rules should be followed at all.
Yes, sir.
Is that true of a developing country?
Yes.
Is that true of India?
Yes, sir, I think.
Why is it like that? Why do we have rules at the same time people don't think that they should follow the rules?
Sir, I will take one example and I will try to elaborate it. Sir, the income tax, there are rules that people have to pay the income tax. But people are not paying the income tax because of, people are thinking that government is not effectively using the income tax amount on the development issues. So people lack belongingness with the government, that the money is not properly used. So people stop paying the income taxes once they feel the confident about.
But isn't it also true that there is a gap between the laws and the society? Laws are probably taken from the West, from the British rule, from the colonial rule, where the society thinks differently. For example, society takes caste is important, whereas the law doesn't give importance to caste. So that can lead to gap between the law and the society. Isn't it, sir?
Yes, sir. As you pointed out, law and order should be close with the society. Mm. The law which came from the legitimacy. Mm. Legitimacy means people's acceptance. So I think instead of imposing the Western model on Southeast Asian model, I think we have to follow a different approach.
So maybe we should accept corruption. Because no. People don't mind corruption.
No, sir. I don't think people should accept corruption, because in the short term it may not affect the rich people, but in the long term it affects all.
It affects all. Okay. Fine. Can you tell me how is Indian administration different from administration in other countries? Something like developed country. Or it is one and the same?
Sir, Indian administration is in the developing stage. Still, we have to give rights to the people.
Okay.
The ability to question. In the Western countries, people demand and get the service. It is a top-bottom-up approach. But in India, still, there are many services the government is providing and people are accepting. Top-down approach.
Okay, this is more top-down,
yes,
elitist.
Sir. Yes, sir. For example, RTI is a bottom-up approach. But there are other RTE Act is there, other laws, SHG movement.
Okay. Mithun,
sir,
what is supposed to be the highest goal of meditation? What does one seek in the end?
Nothing, sir.
Oh, really? What does it mean?
We have to observe the thoughts, and we have to move to a stage that one is not at all concerned with this material world.
We have to observe thoughts.
Yes.
And then?
We have to let it flow. Then a stage should come that nothing is there in his mind.
Nothing is?
Nothing comes into his mind. So it should be completely a ideal stage, completely undisturbed state. Not concerned about any material things which is surrounding him.
You mean, it's not clear, thoughts, you mean not concerned about thoughts or thoughts should not come, what is it?
Sir, the ultimate aim of meditation is to be with yourself, to be with your inner self rather than the material world. But the thoughts come because of the material attachments the body, the soul has. But ultimately the truth is the soul.
So you mean there is really something like soul? And if it is there, where is it?
Sir, scientifically I cannot prove, but I believe there is a soul, sir. I cannot prove that there is a soul, but I believe that there is a soul, sir.
So what does soul have to do with meditation? Did you read any literature on meditation?
No, sir. I did not read the literature on meditation, but I have practiced with a guru, how to do the meditation and how
to.
Who
is that guru?
Sir, under the guidance of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar.
Okay. Okay. He taught you how to meditate.
Yes, sir.
So, what according to him is the end?
When we do meditation, he says one very good line, sir. We have to give the time to ourselves for just 20 or 30 minutes and kick this world with the left leg.
What?
Kick this world, all the material things in a comedy manner, saying that kick this world with the left leg. Don't be concerned with anything.
Okay.
Just relax. This is for yourself. So once the thoughts come, just don't resist. Once you resist, it will persist. So let the flow go. Then the time comes where you don't think of anything. So that is the meditative state.
I mean, not having thoughts.
Yes.
Fine. Thank you. Bye. So, ఎలా అనిపించింది? ఇట్ ఈస్ గుడ్. Good, you are responding, listening carefully. Just one second. Last year you got how many marks? 124. By how many marks did you miss? 174 you should have got. But then, yeah, you did very, very badly. I still remember. Silvo, what is this person? What? Why is he like this? I thought you were an expert, and that is why you didn't come for any mock sessions. But it's good. I gave a good review. And you got? Wow. Thank you. So when I said you get 160, you got 160, and when I disapproved, you got 120. నేను యాక్చువల్లీ మంచి మార్క్స్ ఇచ్చినా ఇవ్వకపోయిన చెడ్డ మార్క్స్ అయితే ఇస్తాను. ఇట్ వాస్ షాకింగ్. ఇట్ వాస్ రియలీ షాకింగ్. బట్ దిస్ గుడ్. You just have no approach problem. It is about what questions they will ask. So basically you are responding to the question, thinking, using common sense. And so, being careful. Yes, yes, honest. Fine, no problem. Honesty makes you relaxed. Makes you relaxed. So you are trying fresh approach, and when I am suggesting something else, you are responding to it. That's all. You need not give theoretically sound answers. The theory is already tested. You cleared it. You just show that you are a man of common sense. Lot of common sense. You can respond. Your first interview also was good.